whatever time left for the discussion and conclusion by our chairman. So the floor is open for discussion.
Yes, we'll have the question and answer session.
Yes, they don't have the energy, so we can...
Well, my thought was, I'm a little confused. I think it relates to what Jaisam said just now, that from 5 years, 10 semesters, or say 9 semesters, we've come down to 8 semesters, and things have been squeezed. But what syllabus we've got here is already been compressed to 8 semesters, correct? Right. Now, is that final or not? I mean, is the council decided on it, and do all the colleges have to implement it, or is it optional? Is VTU, has VTU chosen to do this compression?
What council suggests is minimum standards of education, so we can have higher standard.
Yeah.
And Maharashtra is still following something else.
Can I just briefly? Yeah. The council has suggested 8+2.
It's a suggestion.
It's for us to take it or leave it. And having travelled around the country a little bit, Karnataka was the first to adopt it, and so far it appears that we are about the only state to adopt it. The others, people are still moving very slowly on it, and they are giving reasons for their slow movement without seeming to not conform. Because...
Give the mic there.
I was not part of that adoption committee.
Yeah, we have discussed this once. There is a first meeting held in my college. After that, we have not met and further discussed. Yeah. Guidelines.
They will not stand the scrutiny of courts.
Yes.
It's the universities that have primacy in the Indian educational system.
Yes, correct.
The rest is all suggestive.
One at a time, please.
Pardon?
One at a time, please.
You can? What did
you
say?
Get out of the university. You can become what you call autonomous school of architecture, which is perfectly allowed.
Yeah.
And directly into the council without anything to do. You can.
To get out of the umbrella of the university system, they need a reason, they need a degree. So they always stick to the universities like limpets, as Rajiv Gandhi said. Most of them are not very sure about the value of the properties that they are, of the degrees that they offer, and what value it will have in the market.
See, this is the first time we are even discussing about it. The last time when this happened, that little yellow book, and they crushed it to 8 semesters. Yeah.
If I can give some background, most architecture schools are departments of architecture and colleges of engineering.
Yes.
And because engineering has shifted to a 4-year program nationally, a lot of the architecture students are asking, why can't we get out in 4 years?
Yes.
And many of the colleges haven't worked out a proper response to that question, so they're giving pressure. But I don't think they've really done it. Now they said, okay, one way of responding to it is let's push the students out in 4 years, but they still charge them 5 years fees, which is, as Jason pointed out, is a big rip-off. And I think that should be questioned. But let me just tell you about another trend that is just beginning, because on 31st October I was at a meeting in Delhi, which was a debate that Council of Architecture had organized to discuss amendments to the Architects Act. And I don't know what will emerge finally. A lot of things were discussed, but one thing that there seems to be a broad consensus on is to change from the current process of licensing, where you just get a degree and you get licensed as an architect, to a system where you have to work for a minimum period of 2 years and then sit for a licensing exam, which is an international norm. Mm. 3 years or 2 years is still being debated. They seem to be leaning towards 2 years. And part of the reason for shifting to that is because of international pressures of trade in services, foreign architects wanting to come here. There's a principle of reciprocity that has to be followed. If we want to get opportunity for Indian architects in other countries also. And if we do that, then we'll have to follow processes of licensing that measure up to international standards, which right now we don't have. So that's another pressure. But once we do that, a question which will arise, which has not been asked yet, is then why do we need an internship during the program? Right now the need for an internship is there because our licensing process is faulty. So that will be a corollary that will come up. So I think there seems to be a groundswell of opinion amongst practicing professionals, whoever I've asked the opinion, and people are getting quite worked up about it, that you can't cut the course down from less than 5 years. Internationally, there is no first professional degree, that is a Bachelor of Architecture degree, that is less than 5 years. So I think there will be a lot of pressure to revert back to the five-year system, but when that will happen, I don't know. But you are getting cases like in Karnataka, which is a response to the pressures because of the context of being within engineering colleges, and that engineering is a four-year course internationally now.
Sir, there is the reverse. It's not Rajan. Reverting back. We are, yes. The VTU is running a five-year BR degree program, but in the last BOS, they have pushed it to 8 semesters without even a discussion with public discussion like this. It was done by a few people and they got carried away by engineering lobby. See, this AICT sometimes goes up and council comes down. Sometimes council goes up, AICT comes down. So when AICT went up, they pushed it to four years. But they are calling it 5 years and they are charging the students. Now the students will be up in arms, as what he said. Why are you charging us for one more year? Because we are not coming to the college, we are going to the profession for training. Without mathematics. No, that's what council has told. Mathematics. Diploma. No.
Nath did mathematics with arts, with the humanities. He did sociology, so socio, psycho, and math. And he did the Nata. He got him. Yeah, but we dissuaded him.
Yeah.
So it seems like you do want to have a debate. So when are you going to have that?
Which debate?
About this whole issue. I think there could be at least some forum to discuss this. Yeah. And whether it is in the ambit of the Board of Studies or not, I don't know. But maybe all of us together should have, if there seems to be almost at least some common understanding about whether it should be 5 years plus a licensing process with 2 years of some kind of...
First, let us ask Bangalore University, S.V. Ravindra Harum Salim, what are you doing in Bangalore University now?
4+1.
1 year training. Oh, same thing.
4+1.
Okay. Yes. When you were a student, what was it?
5 years. No training.
No training.
No training at all.
Okay. Sir, when you were a student, what was it? Prem Chandra. Oh, 6 months. Yeah. When I was in IIT, it was only one semester of training in the eight semesters. Somewhere, one semester, and we have to come back and study another 2 semesters and theses and all that. Yeah. So now I have been asked by the registrar to get response from practicing architects. So many of you are here today. Would you like to reduce that practical training to one semester?
You can have one semester training, but they need not be in one office.
No, that is okay. No, sir, that's not the question. The question is, you want it for two semesters, one full year, or you want it for one semester, or you don't want it at all, like he says. No, do you require 9 semesters of studio? Because we are finding this 8 semesters cramped. You know, you are doing housing in 4th semester and all that is ridiculous. It's yes, yes. So we need IIA support. Yeah.
Keeping them only for 4 years.
Yeah.
So where do we reconcile that? How do we reconcile that?
Are we going to like
I think you have one day. You have one day.
No, I have to give you one more information. The madam, the Architects Act 1972 is gazetted and so is 1983. No minimum standards of education. This 2008 is not yet gazetted. So what they have mentioned about training one whole year and all that is not gazetted. It is not in the act. Yeah, we need not adopt it. One at a time. Yeah, the Council of Architecture says one full year, but the VTU has made it 2 semesters. That means 2 months off, 4 months training, 2 months off, 4 months training. Huh? No, now the VTU syllabus says 16 weeks, 16 weeks. It's not 12 months. It's only 8 months. 8 months training. Okay, let us take the decision. We'll raise hands and we'll see. How many of you want it for one full year training? Raise your hands.
No question of one full year.
Ah. No, no, 2 semesters. Hey, one at a time, please. Yes, madam, finish. No, 3.
Okay. So, one would be, of course, this current format.
16 weeks, 16 weeks. Yeah. That is 8 months it becomes.
I have only 16 weeks.
Yes, second one.
The third one does not have any. That means that licensing process is kicking.
No, no, no. That's not possible right now.
Right now.
No, the other thing is 1 year, not just 16 weeks. No, what do you want? What do you suggest?
Without training.
College, no training.
No, no, no.
case scenario, the current situation is to have only one semester of training, but suggest that in the future, I mean, that would be one position, that 10 semesters of coursework, and then 1 year or 6 months or 2 years of training.
So now it is a 5 year degree course. We can have one semester training, two semesters training. Okay. So what do you want, one semester or two semesters?
One.
In the seventh semester. I agree to you.
So,
yes, yes. So seventh or eighth, which semester? Seventh is okay. The, yeah. After you finish that sixth semester of basic course which the council has framed, eighth semester. What about rest of you? You want one semester or two semesters of training? One. S.V. Ravindra. Two. Bangalore University wants to send them out. But if you send them out, you can't call it a 5 year degree course. Then that will happen, what Rama is telling, they will ask for money back. Yeah. Hey, give the mic to Ravindra. Okay. You can shout. Cheers. Which money part?
So the money part, you have to ask the council of architecture, what is the intention and what you are supposed to do about that. Let them give the direction. They can say that it is up to the university or the board of studies to make the final decision. It's okay, perfect. But if it is ambiguous as of now, you cannot take any decision. You have to ask the council to clarify this particular issue.
Okay. Suggested what?
It's 4 plus 1.
Yeah, but that is not gazetted. It's only a guideline. Universities need not take that.
It may get gazetted in future. But since we have to deal with councils, we have to follow its guidelines. Otherwise, we will be fighting with the council every other day in some court.
Yeah, but rest of the country is not following it.
Everyone who is going to be affected.
Professor, rest of the country, ask Rama also. Rest of the country is not following. It is VTU which has taken this up and nobody else has done it. Yeah.
There is more a legal issue rather than this issue here. Because the board, whatever board of studies, in 2009 when they made the decision, they had the same document from COA. Based on that decision, they have taken this 4 plus 1 year. Supposing you make a decision as BOS, probably a student from Brahman Sagar can go to court and just say that how come a BOS from the same university interpreting the same document makes a 4 plus 1 and you are coming back and changing that document based you are also referring to the same document.
No, we are revising syllabus.
No, but you are interpreting based on that. How can you?
Every 3 years syllabus gets revised. No, they can't go to court for that.
But I think you are still not understanding the logic of it. How can you make it now 5 years? On what basis would you make it as 9 semesters plus 1 semester as training? Tell me what would be your basis.
Well, basis? Because you're not able to complete the syllabus.
Yeah, that is a different difference. Then how come the BOS which was there in 2009 was thought that it can make it in 4 or 8 semesters?
They may have been pressurized.
So this
along with engineering lobby.
This pressurized is not a subjective way of looking at it. But when you go to court, probably it has to be. There can be an argument made for that, like that's what you're discussing. Then there can be a legal argument.
Anyway, as S.V. Ravindra said, we will write to the council and find out what are the alternatives possible? Okay.
Because the counseling tomorrow, they refuse to register these students in
No, no, but it's happening already in all Maharashtra schools, it's like that.
9 plus 1.
Yes.
So let us counseling campaign.
Yes.
Without the concept clarification, we could have video does not have any local standing in the subsidiary body of any university.
Oh.
It cannot take any independent stand of its own.
Right, right.
It's just a body it goes to academic connect and it goes to the main meeting system, then only it goes to governor, then it gets approved.
Yes, yes.
So
oh yes. 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 Yeah. Yes. Right now the Right now the COA guideline is you complete thesis formalities in 8 semester and have the Viva OSA in 10 semesters. Yes, right. Then what does he say then? He says you are wrong.
Earlier it was 8 hours, 9 hours, they have reduced to 8 hours.
Our answer, Madi, sir.
They have only recommendation. The last four semesters, in the annual semesters, that is probably about 6 or 7 years. The internship is different, but the amount, one of the question, related question is, how much time is the allotted to design teaching? If you find that it is less, try to increase the design of the
design
of the design of the design of
in the 8 semesters.
9 to 12 hours. You have reduced it from 9 to 8.
Okay.
1 hour per week. So 32 hours per semester.
Yeah. So we have 5 months more before this gets finalized. So we have to have several more meetings and letter writing before we freeze it. Yeah. Pardon? Any more questions? That's for the schools to decide, no? All the schools are having teacher training programs and workshops. No, it's not the BOS jurisdiction to dictate to the schools what to do. We are only bothered with syllabus. This university vice chancellor has mentioned this. I will again pick up this.
Mm.
Yeah, this was discussed in the last joint board of studies, that there are several colleges in rural areas who don't have the expertise. So they are going to set up some satellite center where they are going to broadcast the best in the business. Because everyone can't have the best in the best teachers. So the sharing of teachers through satellite. Yeah. Yeah, right now the board of studies, the board of studies with 9 members and always 2 or 3 being absent, we have a very tough job on hand to frame every line of this syllabus, and we have only 5 months left. So, yeah, any more questions?
Sir, the workshop that you're talking about, unless the board of studies connected, or they won't interact between colleges. Each college will just have its own workshop.
BOS gets direct orders from registrar, okay? So it is IIA which has got academic platform, and so many other bodies are there who can take up this. No? All the schools can have an association. Yeah. There are engineering colleges have associations. We still don't have an association. We don't see eye to eye. And the schools of architecture are competing with each other for intake and other things and grabbing the best teachers. No? Yeah. Shall we conclude here for some more questions? Yeah, I have a suggestion. I have discussed with Bharat also. As a outcome of this BOS, we can have a website created for practicing architects who are interested in education, along with the core faculty, visiting faculty, allied faculty. We create a website, Facebook or whatever you want to create, and let's start interacting first. IIA can also join into that and other associations, no? MASA. Yeah, yes, yes. So, today's interaction seminar, we are calling it interaction seminar because the university objected to the word workshop being used by us, because they are going to have one grand workshop where they may invite all of us again. So they said, don't use that because some money is meant for that. So you change the word. That's why we called it interaction seminar today. And it was tough. Today's discussion was really difficult. And I could feel that most of us are struggling. And some of y'all did very well. Let's go back to the first semester. Vatsala Dokkuna, Arun Swaminathan, Prashant Pol. Excellent discussion on first semester design. Then we had the Lone Ranger, Prem Chandrawarkar, semester 2. Excellent talk by you, sir. I still insist that he is one of the best teachers we have in Bangalore, even though he is not a professor. He is much above a professor because he is into practice as well. Semester 3, Vijay Narnapati, Edgar Di Mello, and S.V. Ravindra did research on the third semester. Very good talks we had. And semester 4, again, Lone Rangers, Deepa and Dinesh, thank you for your good talk. Semester 5, Smaran Malesh, he's not here. Is he here? Yeah, he's here. Srinath Tandur, he's my cousin, by the way. No, most of you don't know. Yeah. Srinath Tandur and Nagaraj Vastare. He didn't show up. Okay. So only 19 showed up finally. 19 presentations. So Srinath Tandur, you stood and spoke like a guru. Excellent talk. And so did Smaran Malesh, very good presentation. Bijay Ramchandran, excellent presentation, sixth semester. Dr. Bhushan, as usual, he speaks well. And Sandeep J also gave us some nice inputs. Semester 7, Anand Krishnamurti, no? Yeah, very good talk. Sujit Nair, you are improving from your previous talk, excellent. And good presentation you gave us. Praveen Bavadekar did not turn up. And then we had finally the thesis stalwarts, Nitya, Soumitro, Anand Krishna, and fantastic talk by Jaisim. Even Anand Krishna spoke very well due to a lot of experience. We can see that. Now, I thank all the 2019 presentations done by our practicing professionals, experts, and the response which we have received, we have recorded it, and we will be again reviewing all those and making notes for our final syllabus contents of each subject. So we have a huge task at hand, and still many of the BOS members keep on absenting themselves. So finally, few of us will have to do all the work. And again, I just end this today's discussion because it's getting late. I agree with Prem Chandarwarkar when he mentioned that architecture belongs to poetry. It is very, very, very true, and it belongs more towards art. It is an art. The skill of synthesis is an art form. And the problem today is we are dominated by technology. The technology has... right. What happened? Can I continue? Yeah. Technology, materials has become very, very dominating in today's situation. So art is now down and technology is up. And if we don't become highly objective and technical, we architects, we will be soon wiped out by this engineering hordes of them. For that matter, even ARCHICAD and the software is being taught to us by engineers. There is no architect coming and teaching the software. And you will find them finally operating outside and we will be left out. So this is the scenario which I predict if we don't become highly technical and objective in our outlook, though it is an art. It is an art, definitely. And the architecture schools which are in engineering colleges have to separate out. This is a very slow process. Even though we have won a court case one year ago exactly, the government of Karnataka has thrown that high court judgment into the shelf. And they are keeping on saying that AICT, we have to follow AICT because we have got integrated engineering campuses where the architecture course is run like an engineering course. When they fill the AICT forms, they make architecture an engineering course, and the principal of the engineering college is our principal. When the council comes for inspection, they all shoo away and they leave us alone and project us as principals and directors and schools of architecture. So this game has been going on. So somewhere down the line, we have to put an end to it. But then on the other hand, all of you also in your lectures today, you have been talking about, collaboration. No? Today's world, everything is collaboration. So being in an engineering campus, we should collaborate with the rest of them, isn't it? So, but they should not dominate over us. We have to be independent and we need our identity. We need to collaborate. But we cannot be given some stepmotherly treatment by the university and the engineering lobby. So it's a huge long fight. I am now fighting for 4 decades virtually. From the first job I entered, I am fighting with the engineering lobby. And even today we are fighting with the engineering lobby. So that is the problem. The schools need to be independent. Why? For example, the concept of a studio we are not able to fulfill because we are in the engineering campus. Otherwise, a standalone architecture school should run for 24 hours. The student should be able to go and work in the studios even in the night. Some of the best schools in the world, they run like that. But because we are in an urban center and we are in engineering campuses, we are not able to do this. So the struggle will go on. It's a long drawn battle between architects and engineers. and on the other hand we have to collaborate, and we are also under the MHRD. Both the COA and the AICT are under the MHRD, and we are called as technical education. That is again, the planning has become technical education. We are also technical education, but we are independent from engineering and technology. So with these few words, I look forward to your support and response, and in the next 5 months we will be again meeting, maybe in groups, subject wise, not in a large group like this. And so I end today's interaction seminar, and I again once again thank the Indian Institute of Architects. Harun Salim is here, and Wadayar is not here today. I also thank Masa for supporting us. Anyone left over? Oh, Masa has disappeared. Oh, okay. And last but not least, Dr. Rama Subramaniam and Dayanand Sagar College of Engineering for providing us this excellent venue. Thank you.